Question number 45. Let y denote the output of the following logical circuit. Here the y is here. G1, G2 are the unknown gate. That is the gate we are going to see. If y, the output is equal to AB, that means these two input plus C bar, D bar. This is two input. So there are totally four input. The gate G1 and G2 must be respectively B. What is the option from the given flow? Whether or NAND or NOR or. So what we are going to do it here means we are going to apply this gate. Then we are going to look at the output whether that output will give this answer. So just that means it's trial and error method. We are going to try first option, second option, third option, and then fourth option. Then we can choose the right answer. Which one is appropriate for G1 and G2? From that, we can choose the right answer.
First, we have to draw the given diagram. Here, in the input A, there is an 1 NOT gate. Then, input B, there is an 1 NOT gate. This gate, we don't know what is a G1. We are going to tell what is the G1. Here it's a 1 gate. This is a gate G2. We don't know what is a gate. The output hits here. Before the output, there is a 2 terminals C and D. Here they are using the NOR gate. The NOR gate, it is connected to the G2. That means here there are 2 input. So the y, the final result would be the given in the question. It should be equal to AB plus CD. This one we are going to use for this solving this problem. We are going to approach from the given solution the options. They are given the first gate. The first gate is the answer A. The first gate is R. The second gate is NAND. The G1 is first gate, G2 is unknown gates. These two are unknown gate. The first unknown gate is R, the second unknown gate is NAND. Suppose if we are putting these two gate, we want to investigate whether we are getting this answer or not. So just we can do it for the first option. The Y is equal to the output. Suppose if this is R, here after the NOT gate, here A bar, here B bar. So after the NOR, what you will get? The sum of the complement. That means you got to sum up the two input A bar, B bar, if it is R. So you got to sum up these two. So that is R. The R gate means the sum of the two input, it will be in the out. So plus there is one more output is coming here. This is NOR. NOR means you got to C plus D, the whole bar, the two input you have to sum up using R. Then if you are taking the complement, that is a NOR operation. So these two we are going to, this is a one input, the another input R, it is coming from the given answer, it is A bar plus B bar. So these two input, the C plus D, we are going to give the G2, guessing is from the given answer, it is NAND. So NAND operation means it's opposite to AND. So AND means the two input, the first input is through the G1 or the second input is through the NOR. So you have to multiply the two input, that means the dot product, and then take the complement. So this is the first given answer, this is a output Y. For solving this one, we are going to use the De Morgan theorem. We know the product of the complement is equal to the sum of the individual complement. That means this is a one input, this is another input. The product of the complement is equal to this is a one more input. The sum of these two complement plus the another input is C plus D bar. So you have to take the sum. Then already from the De Morgan theorem, we know the it's a sum of the complement is equal to the product of the individual complement. That means this is a one dot, this is another. Then you have to take the individual complement. If this is sum, then this is product, but we need to take the complement plus the same manner we are going to do. Here what we are having, the complement we are having, the sum of the complement, that means you need to take the product of the complement C, D. Already the whole bar will be, actually we need to take for first this complement, then we can do that, this operation, inversion. So for this complement, we are going to use the C plus D. It's a C bar, D bar, according to De Morgan theorem, then this whole bar. Here actually, we are inverting that operation, then one more inversion. That means we will get A. Here also, we are doing the same thing. Complement times complement, it's a, actually the quantity, whatever the input, we will get the same output. Similarly, we will get here C plus D. So the given gate G1 or G2 NAND, so this is not a right answer, because our output should be equal to A plus AB plus C plus D, the complement. So we are going to investigate the second option. The second option, actually the B should be equal to the gate G1 is NOR and the gate G2 will be equal to this operation we are going to check. So NOR means, you know what we have to do, so you have to sum up these two input, then you have to take the complement. That means the G1 gate, if it is NOR, A bar plus B bar, then the sum of these two, that output is you have to take the whole complement. This is the first gate output. Now the second gate, we know already the result, C plus D whole bar. We are going to give these two to the unknown gate G2. So C plus D bar, it is also NOR. It's OR operation. That means we are going to use just a plus symbol. This should be equal to, we know the sum of the complement, that should be equal to the product of the complement. So you got to put individually plus. Here also it's a sum of the complement. You can do C dot D, the individual complement. So it should be equal to, it's a complement times complement. It's a B, same manner B. So complement times complement B, it's a B. So this should be equal to, it's a C dot D, it's a whole power. You can call, actually you should call this A. So the in the given answer, the B is the right answer. So we don't want to move the next option to check whether the given unknown gate G1, G2 are right.
So from the discussion, we can conclude that the first gate is NOR gate, the second one is OR gate. So the option 2 is the right answer.